Hi everyone, here is a 2D rig that simulates a 3D head turn in Blender Grease Pencil. In the last video, we set up our character's head turn using action constraints. In this video, we will add audio and set up automatic lip syncing for the mouth, and we'll see the basic steps taken when animating our character. Let's start off by installing the Rhubarb Lip Sync add-on in Blender. I've provided a link to the add-on in the description. I've also provided a link to the official Rhubarb development page. Rhubarb can also be used outside of Blender for a variety of other animation applications. The current version of the add-on, 3.01, bundles Rhubarb Lip Sync by Daniel Wolf, so there's no longer any need to download it separately. Install the version that is applicable to your operating system. Here I select Windows. Once that's done, we open up Blender and select Edit Preferences. Under the Add-ons tab, press the Install button. We then locate the zip file that we just downloaded, and we install it. We check the box to enable the add-on, and we configure its preferences. By default, Rhubarb uses the Pocket Sphinx speech recognition library to detect English words. However, if we're lip-syncing to a different language, we should change this to phonetic. This is language independent and will recognize individual phonemes as opposed to English words and phrases. Here, we'll leave it with the default and save our preferences. Rhubarb uses a pose library, and I'll just demonstrate how that's set up. Let's take a look at our poses to remind ourselves how they should look. First, we have the rest pose, just however the character should look while not speaking. Then we have the labiodental poses, the positions where your lips and teeth touch, like F and V. Next we have the bilabial poses, lips pressed together. This is for sounds like M, B, and P. After this, we have the W and Q shape. This is formed by tightly rounded lips. Next we have the lateral shape. This is used for L. Essentially, it's an open mouth with the tongue lifted high. Then we've got the etc. shape. This is a bit of a catch-all shape, covering a number of different sounds, such as K, S, Z, and others. It's formed by an open mouth with the teeth visible. Next, we have the U shape. This is a larger variant of the WQ shape. Then we have the E shape. Simply an open mouth. It's also used as a transitional pose, as well as other vowels. We continue on to the O shape. This is the largest variant of the rounded lips. Finally, we have the A and I shape. This is the largest shape, where the mouth is opened wide, revealing the teeth and tongue. That's all! These are all of the necessary shapes for English, as well as many other languages. Now, we move on to the Rhubarb setting panel and assign each pose accordingly. We've named our poses using the same naming conventions as Rhubarb and other tools, so this process is pretty straightforward. Next, we assign the sound file that we will be using, as well as the optional transcription file, which can produce better results. Next, in the video sequence editor, we add our sound file so that it can be heard, and we position it where we want the voice to start. Checking the display waveform can help with this. We go to the frame that the audio clip starts and change the video sequence editor to the Dobe Sheet editor. Check what frame we're on, in my case, frame 55. Under the rhubarb settings, we'll set the start frame to 55. Now that we're ready, we can select all of the bones that affect the mouth. In our case, this is just the one bone. However, if you've built a fully rigged mouth, ensure you select all the relevant bones and press Rhubarb Lip Sync. It may take a few seconds, but when it's done, you'll have all of the keyframes ready to go. Before we're finished, we need to select all of our keyframes and press T while hovering over the Dope Sheet editor and select Constant. This will remove all interpolation from our control bone. This is required in our situation. However, if you set up a rigged mouth and its poses, this is optional. So that's it. I'm now fully rigged and animated using Grease Pencil, and I can even talk. All we have to do now is animate the rest of the character. While animating in Blender, it's important to turn on Auto Keyframe. This is the small round button in the timeline. Then, when we move, rotate, and scale the bones at different positions on the timeline, using the keys G, R, and S, keyframes will be inserted automatically. The process I follow when animating is similar to the traditional technique of keyframing. Now that we have the audio and lip syncing done, we'll choose a section of audio, just a sentence or one or two actions, and we can animate that. Here, we're crafting the first introductory action before the talking begins. We polish this section until we can continue onto the next. To do this, we set the first pose, then we begin setting up the key points of the action in question. However, we should only do this for one or two bones at a time, coming back through and focusing on different parts of the action on each pass. I tend to start with the main bones like the head base and the head turn, and we move on to the details later, but this can differ depending on the desired movement. Once the action is done, we offset certain keyframes based on what's leading the action. For example, in this animation, we often have one eyebrow drag a couple of frames behind the other. Sometimes the eyes will look in a direction before the head follows. You'll soon see that we repeat this process multiple times throughout this animation. Trying to give expression to a floating head can be quite difficult, but it's a good exercise, as it limits you to focus on the character's expressions using simple movements, and allows us to fully utilize the head turn we worked so hard on in the last video. As you can see, I've turned off the sound for this video, but if you check the audio scrubbing box under the playback drop-down menu, you'll be able to hear the audio as you animate. This gives you a good reference for timing and expressions. We can scale the head base bone to create some stretch and squash, though make sure to keep the volume of the head consistent. Also, we can use Alt-S when you want to reset the scale. This also applies to translation, Alt-G, and rotation, Alt-R. To make our character more believable, we can make him blink when he turns his head, as well as some semi-random periodic blinks added here and there. These are small but important details. When we start out with animation, it's important to keep it simple. This is why people suggest starting out with the simple movement of a bouncing ball. When it comes to animating characters, we should focus on a single aspect. The movement of a hand with its fingers or the expression of a face and fluid motion of the head. There's a rhythm to animation. Getting hold of that rhythm is important to understand, practice, and eventually master. As we learn to animate, we'll be able to achieve the best results when we use references. This can be in the form of online videos, looking out the window and observing others, or acting it out ourselves. This leads us to be able to notice the little things that give an action meaning. A raised eyebrow, a slight tilt of the chin, a glance to the side, or a nod of the head. Exaggeration is important, especially when animating a simple floating head. It can relate fun and excitement, or express emotion or drama. A floating head may break the laws of reality, but if we keep the actions fluid, giving their movement a sense of natural realism, we will believe the emotions we see. With a little stretch and squash and the versatility of our eyebrow rig, we can demonstrate true purpose and intention. The level of exaggeration is up to us. The less we use, the more realistic a scene may appear. However, with additional exaggeration, we can often convey more emotion and create a more enticing scene. Despite our best intentions to systematically animate our face, it's still possible to forget certain bones for a section or two of animation. This is why it's important to keep your rig minimal, or automate as much as possible, as we did for the glabella lines. Make sure to keep your rigs minimalistic, because if you build too many controls, it can become cumbersome to animate. That's all, we've finished our character. Thank you all for watching and following along. I've seen what some of you have created and I'm truly impressed. If you followed my tutorials, please put a link in the description to your creations. I would love to see anything you've created. Thanks again, I'll leave you here with the render of the final scene. So that's it. I'm now fully rigged and animated using Grease Pencil. And I can even talk. I know that I've learned a lot, and I hope that you have found these tutorials helpful. I've really enjoyed playing around with Grease Pencil, and I'm excited to see what the developers will do next. Hope to see you soon!